Good morning, students. I am Kamal Nath. I welcome you all in the revision video of English for Unit 4. Students, you all know your unit exam is very close and you all must be preparing for that very well. So here we are going to discuss some of the questions from different chapters of your portion. And I'm sure you will listen carefully, you will see it. At the same time, you all will note them down in your copy and please you learn so that you will face the exam nicely, happily, confidently. Here the first chapter that I have taken is here, Night Witches. First is here, Night Witches, you have already read. So the question is here that I have taken, some of the questions that is some is internal question from the chapter, some questions are framed myself here, some questions are from the exercise. So I do suppose that you will take benefit, you will note down in your copy and you will learn. First here question that is from Night Witches. What is the motto of the writer to write this event? The motto of the writer in the chapter Night Witches is to thrill and make the readers aware from the adventures of the war. In this war, of course you have read this chapter and you have seen only the thrills of this war and adventures of the women pilot fighters of Soviet Union. You have read here their great deeds, incredible deeds. So this is the purpose, this is the motto of the writer. The story is serving as the source of motivation for everyone. We get inspiration from the great courage, great determination, great willpower and spirit of the female fighters of Soviet Union. On which aspect of the war she gives stress, she gives force? The writer, it is here talked about the writer, she is here the writer of this story. The writer gives stress on the bravery of the women fighters, pilots of Soviet Union. She describes her indomitable part, spirit, which led the war in different way. She is describing those air pilots as indomitable spirit, which led, that indomitable spirit led the war in different way, in different direction. The brave women fighters of Soviet Union proved in the war that arms and resources were not sufficient to face the war, but spirit and persistence played greater role in the war. So let us see now next question here. What was the sad aspect of the war? That was the negative just aspect of the war, you can say. The writer tells that the female fighter pilots struggled so hard during the war, yet they could not earn the respect of their brothers in arms, means as much honor and respect the male members got in the army, they could not really earn that fame and name and the honor. What role did Stalin play in the creation of the female regiments? You have heard the name Stalin. The Night Bomber Regiment was one of the three female fighter pilots units which were created by Stalin at the insistence of Marina Raskova, who was an aviation celebrity. You have heard Marina Raskova, a great celebrity and aviation celebrity. She trained her recruits as pilots and navigators and also as members of crews. Let us see now next. Now you have been given some statement from the line, from the textbook, and the questions are based on that line, based on that statement. So these questions are from another chapter of your portion, The Wolves of Kernogrez. You have read and you remember everything. This was what here written by Hector Hug Munro. You must learn the writer's name, the poet's name, the poetess name, and their biography as well, the short biography. I have detailed you up before starting any poem or chapter. So please you do remember, learn them, forever for your good exam. Read the lines and answer the questions. Everyone turned and looked at her in astonishment. Surprise. Astonishment, surprise. Which woman is referred to here? Amele, the old governess, is referred to here. You are remembering? Very well, you remember Amele. Why did everyone look at her in astonishment? Everyone looked at her in astonishment because she usually remained silent and did not give her opinion or reaction in any discussion or any activity. So her interference, all of a sudden interference, surprised everyone who were sitting there. Now let us see her next one. It was an impertinence. This is another statement now from the story, an extract from the story. Who said these words? How did he or she speak? And why? These words were told by the Baron. Baron is what here? Dignity only, not a name here, dignity. He didn't believe the story of the old governess, so he said these words mockingly at her. What was the impertinence and why was it considered as impertinence? The story which the governess said about the castle, howling of the wolves, and introducing herself as the member of the Kernogreys family, this was all here considered as the impertinence. The way, in the manner she has told that all about herself was impertinence. The Baron told that manner impertinence. Let us see next. One is sorry for her, of course, but it is extremely annoying all the same. Who said, who is the speaker here, and who was he or she referring to? A speaker is the Baroness. She is referring to the dying old governess who was dying. Why was the speaker both annoyed with and sorry for the person? The speaker was annoyed because the house was full of guests at that time. It was the season of festivities, and so the house was full of guests, and the governess had fallen ill and had confined herself in her room. She was sorry as well because she had never been so seriously ill, but an indifferent part of the family. The governess had been the indifferent part of her family. Next is here, do you think the speaker really felt both annoyed and sorry? Why do you think so? Yes, the speaker felt annoyed because in absence of her, she was not able to manage her guests. She was sorry because she was sympathetic towards her as well. Now there are some questions from the poem, very interesting poem, Break, Break, Break. You remember very well. Who or what is being addressed in the first line? The wave of the sea is being addressed in the first line of the poem. You remember the first line of the poem. The poet is telling the wave of the sea to break on the cold gray stones. In the first stanza, what does the speaker wish he could do? What does he say about his state of mind? In the first stanza, the speaker expresses his helplessness, lamenting that he cannot give voice to his thoughts. He was unable to speak, he was unable to express his grief, his pain, his thoughts. He was not able to organize his idea and give a concrete shape. Then he tells that he is so grieved after the loss of his friend that he has no word to express his pain and sadness. Now let us see here, next one. Who are the people mentioned in the second stanza? Where are they and what are they doing? In the second stanza, the poet has mentioned three people. The fisherman's son and his sister are playing and shouting happily on the sea shore. So these are the two people, son and his sister, fisherman's son and his sister. At the same time, a sailor lad is singing songs in the boat on the bay. So in this way, three people are mentioned in that second stanza. The poet is trying to tell the difference of the state of his own mind and the mood of those people in the sea, how they are looking, in which mood they are, and he is talking about his own mood, in which mood he is. Read the third stanza. What does the speaker mention that has remained unchanged, and what has changed? We have to discuss both. In the third stanza, the poet mentions the grand and big ship which is going to the heaven, to the safe place, peaceful place under the hill. It's a destination under the hill. This is continuous process which has not changed. It is as usual, and that activity was going on. On the contrary, means opposite of that, the poet is feeling sad and loneliness alone because he has lost his friend. He cannot now touch his friend's hand because he is no more alive now. He cannot hear the sound of his beloved friend. So this was what here some of the questions, and rest, that is here objective, some of the objective questions I will discuss in the class, online class student. So these were not here all the just question answers. We have some more. We will discuss in the class as well, in just large scale, so that you can be conscious about that portion and you will prepare for the exam. Thank you, student. Thank you for being in the class, listening to me. Thank you all.